Okay, so let's ask the question, why should you learn to program the computer? And really, we first have to admit that the answer to my question might be, hello, no, I don't need to do this. I'm interested in lots of stuff, and this does not interest me. And that's pretty reasonable. I mean, first of all, you should make sure you go outside. Run around, physical exercise is very important. Food is delicious, talking to people is wonderful. I don't know, hobbies, I like playing cards, I like musical theater. I don't necessarily need programming for those things. So you can go and have a very full life and just stop these videos and really be a happy person. At the same time, let's just admit something. You probably use the computer a lot. It's probably a tool for work, family, social, you use it, right? And how do you use it? Let's say you've never written a line of code before in your life. You probably do things like you use Chrome, or you use Photoshop, or you use Word, or we could keep making a long list of stuff there. What are all these things? Software. Who made these things? Not you, right? So, they're great. Photoshop is really good and an amazing piece of software made by a very large company and lots of people. And you need Photoshop. You have an image. You want to get rid of the red eye. You want to make it brighter. You want to do some kind of, filter on it to make it look like it was taken 30 years ago. I don't know if Photoshop does that. You use Photoshop. But there are limits to what Photoshop can do. It is a tool with a set of features that are provided to you via an interface, and you can't make it do more than it does. And in fact, if you want to be creative, if you want to develop your own ideas, whether they're art or a commercial product or some just weird, strange exploration, you don't want to be limited by the tools that are provided for you. You want to start with a blank slate. If you want to create a new image processing filter that doesn't exist, you could do that. In this video series, you will learn to do that, and it's not very hard. I mean, there are aspects of programming that are incredibly hard. This won't be easy, don't get me wrong, but this is really what we're talking about here. Everything that you do, whether it's working with images, working with animation, writing, checking your email, interfacing with hardware, robotics, there's everything that you do digitally starts from somewhere. Somebody wrote the software to make this stuff work. Why couldn't that person be you? What types of things could you invent? What types of ideas could you come up with if you weren't limited to the list of tools that you can download, purchase, and get from other individuals who might have released it as open source or big companies? Let's break all those bonds. Let's write your own software. That sounds very grand and ridiculous. And then we're going to be like, and now what you're going to learn is there's a red circle on the screen and it moves back and forth. So don't get me wrong. This is going to be a slow process. This is really just the beginning. I'm going to show you some basic stuff. You're going to have to take it much farther. But this will get you started in that direction. And hopefully will be great. Now, there's also the question, this is maybe why you should learn, how you should learn. That's a more complicated one. I'm not prepared to answer it. I'm just going to try as best I can to communicate to you and provide resources. But again, this just brings up the question, there are so many resources online that are terrific. There are online courses you could take. There's Code Academy. There's the Khan Academy. There's Udacity. There's schools you can go to. There's a new experimental school called the School for Poetic Computation that's opening. There's lots of stuff out there. So this is just a little resource through video. I'll try to supplement it with code examples online, with links below the video. I might hopefully create a site with some other tools at some point. But right now, me talking, examples you can download, diagrams. But there is something that I think is important to mention here, which is a lot of the tools that you might, first of all, you know what's a nice way to learn? Find a friend, find somebody you don't even know, sit in a room with other people, try to program with them, ask them questions, look at what they're doing, try to explain your program to a friend, be with people, right? We can all try to design the most fancy, best, whatever online tool that will like show you the steps and give you immediate feedback and step you through and give you this exercise and give you all this, right? But being with people and talking to people and talking through your ideas. That is probably the best way to learn. Now, that's not what's happening here. I'm by myself, which is a little bit weird, but I'm getting used to it, a lot more used to it than I was before. But one thing that I will say also that's a little bit different here is a lot of the tools and courses, you know, that you might take, whether it's a high school class, a college class, an online class, first of all, they might have the word computer science in them. Computer science is a really great field of research and study of the science of computing. This is not that. We are just learning about computation, how to write programming, how to write code, how to program, and applying it to whatever you might be interested in. Are you interested in biology? And could the tools of computation help you there? Are you interested in music? And could the tools of computation be something you could use with music? And this is the other thing. I don't have a test for you to take. I don't have something to say like, and you will make this when you're finished with these videos. The point of these videos is for you to have a creative idea. And you don't have to have that now. You might get inspired or try experiments, and it doesn't have to have any practical value. Now, you might want to get a job, which I think is important in a lot of ways, but you might also just be like, I like sorbet, and I like bugs, particularly spiders, and I'm going to create a simulation of spiders eating sorbet, which actually, now that makes no sense whatsoever, but that's the point. You might have some idea that apparently doesn't have any practical value that makes any sense, but you just want to explore it. It could be a visual idea. It could be a musical idea. It could be a website, an app. This isn't really going to be about making products and apps and stuff for the web, as you're going to see as much, but the point is, you will develop your own ideas and make them and hopefully share them with others in some way. So this is not going to, I will try to give little exercises and little questions and push in particular directions, but how you will learn in this particular context will be about coming up with your own creative project ideas and using the tools of computation to realize those ideas. And hopefully, that will be a nice thing. If anybody has success with that and finds it useful, I'd be thrilled to know. Okay, so that's the end of this particular introductory video. And I think the next one is I'm going to talk about actually what is programming. What does it mean to write? What is programming? What is an algorithm? What does it mean to program the computer?